Hello and welcome to the 7 o'clock news from Bahrain International. I'm Sarah Lebrek. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa took part alongside Arab kings, princes and presidents in the opening session of the first Arab EU summit, which was inaugurated by Egyptian President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi at the International Conference Center in Sharm el-Sheikh. Addressing the opening session of the first Arab EU summit, His Majesty the King said that the Arab region has always been a cradle of tolerance, pluralism and peaceful coexistence between religions. His Majesty the King took pride in Bahrain's strides in this regard, urging concerted efforts to protect and consolidate these lofty values which represent the cornerstone of global peace. His Majesty the King also noted that history has always revealed that security, stability and development are inseparable all over the world, stressing the necessity of strengthening the alliance to eradicate terrorism, deal firmly with terror sponsors, bolster collective cooperation and coordination on the basis of mutual respect and balanced international relations and strategic interests. Before the session began, His Majesty the King shook hands with the Egyptian president, who welcomed His Majesty, expressing his thanks for accepting the invitation and participating in the summit.
الملك حمد بن عيسى آل خليفة ملك مملكة البحرين الشقيقة لإلقاء كلمته فليتفضل.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. فخامة الرئيس عبد الفتاح السيسي رئيس جمهورية مصر العربية الشقيقة، أصحاب الجلالة والفخامة والسمو والمعالي والسعادة، معالي السيد دونالد تاسك رئيس المجلس الأوروبي، معالي السيد أحمد أبو القيط أمين العام لجامعة الدول العربية، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أتوجه بداية بخالص الشكر والتقدير لفخامة الرئيس عبد الفتاح السيسي على استضافة جمهورية مصر العربية الرائدة بمبادراتها والسباقة في مواقفها لأعمال هذه القمة التاريخية بحضورها الرفيع وأجندتها الهامة التي نتطلع إلى نجاح مباحثاتها وتحقيقها لأهدافها المرجوة في تغريب المواقف بين الحلفاء والأصدقاء على الجانبين العربي والأوروبي، وأن تشمل قراراتها حلول متجددة لمعالجة قضايا طال حلها، وصولا لما ننشده جميعا من استقرار عالمي وسلام إنساني يتيح للبشرية صفو العيش ودوام الرخاء والازدهار. إن الاستثمار في الاستقرار قد أصبح حاجة ملحة لا تحتمل التأجيل في ظل ما تواجهه منطقتنا من نزاعات وتهديدات مستمرة ومواقف غير مسؤولة تتمثل في احتضان قوى التطرف والإرهاب والتدخل في الشؤون الداخلية وعدم احترام سيادة الدول وإرادة الشعوب وانتهاك كافة القوانين والمواثيق الدولية والاستمرار في تجاهل كل ما يصدر من قرارات لحفظ أمن الدول وسلامة مواطنيها. ولعله من المناسب أن تشهد مباحثاتنا من خلال هذه المنصة الحوارية المزيد من التفاهم وتقارب الرأي للتوافق حول كيفية احتواء التحديات القائمة إلى يومنا هذا، بالنظر إلى ما نشهده جميعاً من تبعات عديدة تلقى بظلالها غير المحمودة على جهودنا لتنمية مستدامة وشاملة، مما يستدعي العمل على حماية مصالحنا المتبادلة القائمة على تعاون تاريخي. عملنا معاً على تعميقه وتقويته في العديد من المجالات النوعية، ومن بينها قطاع الطاقة الذي تبلغ نسبة ما تصدره الدول العربية لأوروبا وحدها ما يقارب 65% من ناتج هذا القطاع، كما يبلغ حجم التبادل التجاري 315 مليار يورو ويعادل 8.4% من إجمالي التجارة الدولية للاتحاد الأوروبي، الأمر الذي يؤكد متانة تعاوننا المشترك الذي نسعى من خلاله بالعمل الجاد لتحقيق الأجندة العالمية للتنمية المستدامة. أصحاب الجلالة والفخامة والسمو والمعالي والسعادة، إن منطقتنا كانت دائماً ولا تزال مهداً للتسامح والتعددية والتعايش السلمي بين الأديان، ونمتلك في البحرين تجربة واقعية نفتخر بها ونرى في تكثيف الجهود اتجاه حماية وتعزيز هذه القيم أهمية كبرى لإحلال السلام العالمي، إذ أثبتت التجارب والدروس التاريخية على الدوام بأن الأمن والاستقرار والتنمية كل لا يتجزأ في العالم أجمع، وإذا صاب الضرر طرف تضررت بقدره باقي الأطراف المجاورة له، ولا بديل لمواجهة ذلك إلا بتقوية أوجه التحالف للقضاء على الإرهاب وعدم التهاون مع من يرعاه، والعمل على رفع مستويات التعاون والتنسيق الجماعي وسيادة الاحترام المتبادل والتوازن في العلاقات الدولية والمصالح الاستراتيجية. وتؤكد مملكة البحرين في هذا الشأن بأن من أهم الأسباب التي تؤدي إلى الاستقرار هو الوصول لحل عادل وشامل للقضية الفلسطينية وحصول الشعب الفلسطيني على حقوقه المشروعة ودولته المستقلة كاملة السيادة وعاصمتها القدس الشرقية، وفقاً لمبادرة السلام العربية وقرارات الشرعية الدولية ذات الصلة. وهذا مطلب لن تحيد عنه كافة الشعوب العربية والإسلامية. ومن جانب آخر، فإن إيران مستمرة في تعكير صف واستقرار الدول العربية بتدخلاتها في شؤونها الداخلية، وهي المصدر الرئيسي الذي يدعم المنظمات الإرهابية في المنطقة وتهدد ببرنامجها للصواريخ البالستية الأمن والسلم الإقليمي والدولي. وعلينا جميعاً أن نوقف هذه الممارسات الخطيرة ونتصدى لهذا البرنامج المخالف للقوانين الدولية، كما نؤكد على ضرورة إبقاء المنطقة خالية من الأسلحة النووية وغيرها من أسلحة الدمار الشامل لتفادي أي سباق للتسلح لا يحمد عقباه بما يؤثر على ما نصب إليه من تنمية وازدهار واستقرار. ولا يفوتنا في ختام كلمتنا أن نتوجه بالشكر للمسؤولين بجامعة الدول العربية والاتحاد الأوروبي على جهودهم الكبيرة في التحضير والإعداد لهذه القمة، مكررين تقديرنا لفخامة الرئيس عبد الفتاح السيسي على ما بذلته جمهورية مصر العربية الشقيقة من مساعٍ حثيثة لاحتضان أعمال القمة العربية الأوروبية وتحقيقها لأهدافها النبيلة، شاكرين لفخامته ولشعبه الكريم حسن الوفادة وكرم الضيافة. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa al-Khalifa met the custodian of the two holy mosques, King Salman bin Abdulaziz Al Saud, in Sharm el-Sheikh on the sidelines of their participation in the Arab-EU summit in Egypt. His Majesty the King and the Saudi monarch highlighted the strong historic relations between Bahrain and Saudi Arabia, which is witnessing a constant development in various fields. They expressed pride in the strength of relations between the two countries and their keenness on developing cooperation mechanisms on various levels in a way that serves the country's joint interest. His Majesty valued the honorable stances of the Saudi monarch and his support for Bahrain and his people under all circumstances, as well as his efforts in strengthening Bahraini-Saudi relations. They also discussed a number of regional and international developments and important issues and topics on the agenda. They expressed aspirations that this summit will result in the strengthening of Arab-European relations and promote cooperation on all levels to achieve joint goals. His Majesty the King expressed appreciation and pride in Saudi Arabia's role in supporting Arab causes, defending its interests, and ensuring the unity of Arab efforts in facing challenges. The meeting was attended by the Bahraini and Saudi delegations. On the sidelines of the Arab-EU summit, His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa met yesterday His Highness the Emir of Kuwait, Sheikh Sabah Al Ahmed Al Jaber Al Sabah, at the International Conference Center in Sharm El Sheikh. The meeting reviewed the outstanding historic relations linking the two countries and means of enhancing them on all levels. His Majesty the King and the Emir of Kuwait stressed the continuous efforts to develop mechanisms of joint cooperation between Bahrain and Kuwait in all fields. The meeting also discussed and exchanged views on regional developments. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received today the United Arab Emirates member of the Federal Supreme Council, ruler of the Emirate of Fujairah, and head of the UAE's delegation participating in the first Arab EU summit, His Highness Sheikh Hamad bin Mohammed Al Shargi, on the sidelines of His Majesty's participation in the summit at Sharm el Sheikh. The ruler of Fujairah conveyed the greetings of UAE's President, His Highness Sheikh Khalifa bin Zayed Al Nahyan, UAE Vice President, Prime Minister, and Dubai ruler, His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid Al Maktoum, and the Crown Prince of Abu Dhabi and Deputy Supreme Commander of the UAE Armed Forces, His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Zayed Al Nahyan, and their wishes of progress and prosperity to Bahrain and its people under the leadership of His Majesty the King. His Majesty asked him to convey his greetings to the Emirate leadership and his wishes of further progress and prosperity to the Emirate people. His Majesty the King welcomed His Highness Sheikh Hamad bin Mohammed and affirmed the depth of historic relations between the two countries, which are based on cooperation and coordination in various fields. His Majesty hailed the high status of the UAE at the international level and the achievements it made in various fields thanks to the wise leadership. He also hailed the effective role in defending Gulf causes and interests, supporting Arab and Islamic affairs, and serving security and stability in the region. They discussed a number of topics of mutual concern and topics listed on the summit's agenda. His Highness Sheikh Hamad bin Mohammed praised the efforts of His Majesty the King in strengthening brotherly relations between the two countries, affirming that bilateral relations will always receive the support of both leaderships. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa also received today the Prime Minister of Lebanon, Saad Al Hariri, in Sharm El Sheikh on the sidelines of the first Arab EU summit. He conveyed the greetings and appreciation of the Lebanese President, Michel Aoun, to His Majesty the King and his wishes of progress and prosperity to the people of Bahrain. His Majesty welcomed the Lebanese Prime Minister and asked him to convey his greetings to President Aoun and wished the Lebanese people further progress and prosperity. His Majesty the King hailed the brotherly bilateral relations and the level of cooperation in various fields, affirming Bahrain's support of Lebanon's efforts in maintaining its national unity, sovereignty, stability, and security. The meeting also discussed the current situation in the region, regional and international developments, as well as issues of mutual concern. His Majesty wished Al-Hariri success in his efforts to achieve the aspirations of the Lebanese people. For his part, Al-Hariri expressed pleasure in meeting with His Majesty and expressed thanks for the kingdom's keenness to support Lebanon to strengthen its unity and ensure its safety and security. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received today the French Foreign Affairs Minister Jean-Yves Le Drian at the International Conference Hall in Sharm El Sheikh. As part of His Majesty's participation in the first Arab-European summit held in Egypt, during the meeting, the two sides reviewed the course of the close historic and friendly relations and cooperation between the two friendly countries in light of the joint efforts to strengthen them in various fields. His Majesty hailed the advanced level of Bahraini-French relations and the continuous development of bilateral cooperation to serve the interests and aspirations of the two friendly people. His Majesty expressed appreciation to the French President Emmanuel Macron for his keenness and interest in developing friendship ties with Bahrain, noting France's active role at the regional and global levels and its tireless efforts to enhance international security and peace. His Majesty also reviewed with the French Foreign Minister a number of topics discussed at the Arab-European Summit, which serve the fields of cooperation and the enhancement of Arab-European dialogue. For his part, the French Foreign Minister expressed thanks and appreciation for the King's support and encouragement for all efforts aimed at developing bilateral relations and increasing for cooperation and coordination, hailing the pivotal role of Bahrain as an important partner in establishing security and stability in the region. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa attended yesterday a dinner banquet hosted by Egyptian President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi in honor of Arab leaders and representatives of friendly countries and associating delegations, marking their participation in the first Arab-European summit held in Sharm el-Sheikh. His Majesty the King exchanged cordial talks with Arab and friendly country leaders about Bahrain's bilateral relations and cooperation with their countries in various fields. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa left Egypt today after heading Bahrain's delegation to the first Arab-European summit, which held its final sessions in Sharm el-Sheikh. His Majesty sent a cable to the President of Egypt, Abdel Fattah al-Sisi, expressing thanks and appreciation for the warm welcome and hospitality. He affirmed pride in the strength of relations connecting Bahrain and Egypt on all levels, expressing appreciation for al-Sisi's efforts on promoting means of cooperation between Arab and European countries. He noted that his ideas and visions had a clear role in the development and stability of Arab and European countries, as well as enabling them to face various challenges. Al-Mashti asserted that Bahrain will remain a firm supporter for Egypt under all circumstances, wishing Egypt and its president happiness and prosperity. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa returned to the Kingdom of Bahrain today after heading the Bahraini delegation to the first Arab EU summit, which concluded its sessions in Sharm el Sheikh. His Royal Highness the Deputy King Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa met with His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa today at Ghadabiyya Palace. During the meeting, the Royal Highness has affirmed the importance of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa's speech during the Arab-European Summit, which determined Bahrain's approach of facing challenges, particularly terrorism, interference in internal affairs, supporting the efforts of achieving peace and world stability. They stressed the importance of the topics discussed during the summit, which provided a dialogue platform between the Arab and European sides to achieve further coordination and cooperation. The Royal Highnesses also discussed local affair topics, so where His Royal Highness the Deputy King and His Royal Highness the Prime Minister asserted that the government's continuous adoption of initiatives that guarantee integrating citizens and job seekers in the labor market. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa chaired today the weekly cabinet meeting at Ghadabiyya Palace. After the meeting, the Cabinet Secretary General Dr. Yasser bin Isa Al Nasser made the following statement. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister hailed the speech of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa during the Arab-European summit that was held in Sharm el Sheikh, Egypt. The cabinet noted the importance of the summit and its outcomes of increasing Arab-European cooperation and bolstering joint understanding between the two sides and various challenges faced by the Arab and European countries, particularly terrorism. The cabinet hailed the efforts of Egypt, led by President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi, in providing the atmosphere that guaranteed the success of the summit. The cabinet also commended His Majesty's patronization and attendance of sports events for the encouragement and support it provides to the youth sector. The cabinet noted the importance of art events in supporting the cultural movement, praising the role of fine art exhibitions and the government's keenness on continuing to hold, including the fine art exhibition held under the patronage of His Royal Highness the Prime Minister and inaugurated by the Deputy Prime Minister His Highness Sheikh Ali bin Khalifa Al Khalifa. His Royal Highness directed all ministries and government authorities to welcome feedback from all citizens and the press and to address their complaints. The Cabinet approved a draft law amending certain provisions of Decree Law 78 of the year 2006 regarding unemployment insurance. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister, Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa, launched the National Program of Employment upon the recommendation of the coordinating committee headed by His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander, and First Deputy Prime Minister, Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa. The program aims to give the Bahraini citizen priority in employment and maintain the flexibility of the labor market and is considered a national plan to increase employment opportunities for citizens in the labor market upon the directives of His Royal Highness the Prime Minister and His Royal Highness the Crown Prince. The cabinet approved the state's general budget of the fiscal year 2019-2018 and referred the draft law to the Representatives' Council. The budget took into consideration the restructuring of the general budget and balancing between the government revenue and expenditure without affecting citizens' main services, including health, education, and social services. The cabinet approved a number of Arab protocols and conventions, including the Arab Convention on the Regulation of Transplantation and Transplantation of Human Organs and Tissues and the Prevention and Combating of Trafficking in them, the Arab Convention on Prevention and Combating Human Cloning, the Arab Protocol to Prevent and Combat Maritime Piracy and Armed Robbery, and the Arab Protocol to Prevent and Combat Trafficking in Persons, especially women and children. The Cabinet referred to the Ministerial Committee of Legal and Legislative Affairs draft laws for the amendments of Decree No. 197 of the year 2014 concerning the countries whose citizens can obtain electronic visas to enter Bahrain and the amendments of Decree 4 of the year 2010 on the conditions and procedures of issuing visas for citizens of countries that grant visas to enter Bahrain and residents of the GCC countries. The Cabinet discussed the reform of the National Chronic Diseases Prevention Committee and referred it to the Ministerial Committee for Legal and Legislative Affairs. The Cabinet discussed organizing the request for exceptional subsidies for clubs participating in foreign tournaments in accordance with a unified mechanism on the basis of specific objective conditions. The Council referred a draft law in this regard to the Ministerial Committee for Legal and Legislative Affairs after studying the memorandum submitted for this purpose by the Minister of Youth and Sports Affairs. The Council of Representatives Speaker Fawzia bint Abdullah Zainal hailed His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa's launch of the National Employment Program based on the recommendation of the Coordinating Committee chaired by His Royal Highness the Crown Prince Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa. This aims to give preference to the Bahraini citizens and enhance his chances to be the first choice of employment in the labor market, while maintaining the flexibility of the labor market to attract capabilities. She pointed out that the Program for Employment affirms the cooperation between the legislative and executive authorities in implementation of the directives of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa to promote positive cooperation for the country and the citizens. The Speaker affirmed that there is a parliamentary request and general agreement to refer a draft law amending some provisions of Decree Law No. 78 of the year 2006 regarding insurance against unemployment for the importance of the national program and its benefit for the country and its citizens. She added that the government's response to the parliamentary demands in launching the National Employment Program affirms the keenness of all to meet the aspirations of the country and the citizens. She stressed that the program will receive parliamentary support as a national plan to increase employment opportunities for citizens in the labor market. She called on all national establishments and citizens to positively and responsibly interact with the National Employment Program and achieve its goals. The chairman of the Shura Council, Ali bin Saleh Al Saleh, hailed the speech delivered by His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa at the opening session of the first Arab-European summit held in Sharm el-Sheikh, Egypt. Al Saleh affirmed the importance of His Majesty the King's support for further understanding and consensus on the means of overcoming the existing challenges, noting His Majesty's highlighting of Bahrain's experience of tolerance, pluralism, and peaceful coexistence among religions. The president of the Shura Council stressed the importance of strengthening alliance to eliminate terrorism and to work on raising the levels of cooperation and collective coordination. Al Saleh expressed full support for the kingdom's stance, which His Majesty affirmed in his speech, in the importance of reaching a just and comprehensive solution to the Palestinian cause. He also noted the importance of addressing Iranian terrorism that threatens the security and stability of the region. A press conference was held at Ghudaybiya Palace discussing the details of the initiatives of the National Employment Program. These spokespeople in the conference were Minister of Finance and National Economy, Sheikh Salman bin Khalifa Al Khalifa, Minister of Labor and Social Development, Jamil bin Mohammed Hamedan, Chairman of the Labor Market Regulatory Authority and Parliament Affairs Minister, Ghanem bin Fadl Al Bu'aynin, Minister of Industry, Commerce and Tourism, زايد بن راشد الزياني Minister of Youth and Sports, أيمن توفيق المؤيد, and Dr. إبراهيم بن محمد جناحي, Executive Director of the Tamkeen Labor Fund. A number of ministers and officials affirmed their keenness on executing all the National Employment Program initiatives launched by His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander, and First Deputy Prime Minister, Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa, to achieve the goal of assigning Bahraini citizens with appropriate jobs. They express aspirations for everyone involved to cooperate in making this program a success, to serve the interests of Bahraini job seekers, stressing their commitment to the implementation of the National Employment Program, which will contribute to the enhancement of quality and appropriate employment opportunities for citizens.